Now, she's the soul singer who Amy Winehouse once proclaimed you have to see at least three times in your life before you die. We're talking about Carleen Anderson, of course. Known for her music, Carleen is now embracing a new chapter in her life with this three-part series known as Cage Street Memorial, incorporating a book, a CD, and a theatre production. It's a story about two teenagers wildly in love but never to be together, as well as her upbringing by her paternal grandparents, who by all accounts saw her as a surrogate daughter after the loss of their own. Before we talk to Carleen about that, let's hear her in action.
I saw her running to find out if she'd been misplaced. How could I be lost? Stop the world, let me get off. No peace could she find. The devil kept messing with her mind. The girl was so tough, but one day she had enough. Pardon the miss, she's got a right to have a nervous breakdown. Whoa.
The amazing, the astonishing Carleen joins me now. Thank you very much indeed for coming in. I don't even know where to begin. I mean, your pedigree is so huge. I mean, coming from your family background, your mother used to sing with James Brown. I mean, Bobby Bird, who was her husband, was, you know, the person who discovered James Brown. Now you're an absolutely huge star. I mean, how have you evolved?
Well, I didn't plan on doing any of this myself. When you have this kind of thing going ahead of you, the last thing, well, for me anyway, the last thing I wanted to do was to go into this business. But I just got called on it to come to be on the show with my stepfather, Bobby Bird, and the rest of them, my birth mother, Vicki Anderson, Maceo Parker, Lynn Collins, Fred Wesley, Pee Wee Ellis, they all came over to England, and I was just the opening. They needed an opening act because all of these were stars and no one wanted to go on first.
But of course, you're not just a singer, you're now also a writer as well as a theater producer. Tell me a bit about the project you're working on.
Well, this project, Cage Street Memorial, began because I wanted to honor my grandparents. My paternal grandparents raised me from infancy, and I wanted to tell the story about them because they are the people in many people's lives. They get lost in the whole process of it. And then during my research for them, I found that it was necessary to write a book in order to give the background for the theater production and the music itself. So the music in the book serves as a prop to the actual
right, but what I understand is it's described as a sort of hybrid. It's using digital imagery, omni-sound, combining several styles of music and cultural expressions from Shakespeare to soul music. Is this, in a sense, an acknowledgement of your multi-layered experience?
Exactly. It's definitely that. I've kind of coined the phrase calling it a tribal opera. Now,
I like that.
Since it was, there wasn't a definition out there that I felt that housed all of the things that it's, I wanted it to be a very 21st century way of producing a theater production. So I say tribal in the sense, not of an exclusivity, but in the sense of having everything and then you having all of these different places that you've come from and things that you've learned from, and then still having it come from this one bloodline.
Now, obviously, all these are works in the making. They're not quite ready yet, are they?
Well, the book is complete,
right,
and the album is complete. The theater production has been granted an award from the Arts Council. So that's the one that's the most in development. But the book is finished and the album is finished. So
right,
the props are ready.
Brilliant. Congratulations. But just before we go, Amy Winehouse said that everybody had to see you at least three times. What's your relationship with her?
Well, with Amy, I met Amy early days, long before she was famous, and we did some shows together. This was long before she was known, and she would just hang around and stuff, and it was... That's how
remarkable woman, though, isn't she?
Excellent.
Remarkable voice.
Excellent.
Yeah, but just briefly before you go, I mean, just you must have seen the movie, that James Brown movie. Did it? Because you must know all the characters who were, I mean, the people who the characters were representing. Was that a true depiction of James Brown?
I think for Hollywood, they did really good. I think they did pretty fairly, and they treated my stepfather really well. So I think they did really well.
Well, Carleen, I've got to say it's a real pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much
indeed for coming in, and good luck with all your projects.
Thank you.
Anderson there.